America, saying we open the space for African countries. And what are they opening space for? Textile. We will now, whether it is in Lesotho, whether it is in Nigeria or Nairobi, Kenya, our women and our young men are sewing jeans and other apparel which are taken to supermarkets in the United States of America. And once they have worn them and they are tired of them, they created another export opportunity of second-hand clothing. And second-hand clothing, that is why the textile industries in Kaduna in Nigeria died. That is why textile companies in Kenya, whether it was Rivertex, whether it was Kikomi, whether it was Mountex, they all died. Because Europe was now telling us, what we have consumed and rejected, you Africans must now consume. And when recently the Rwandese and the Ugandans said that we were going to stop the importation of second-hand clothing, they threatened us with sanction. Africa is meant to treat us new, which Europe and America has rejected. That is the Africa that you want me to talk about. So when we talk about this continent of Africa, there have been no shortage of attempts to help her. And for her to help herself. I remember on the 6th day of March 1997 in Accra, Ghana, the former president of Tanzania, Mwalimu Julius Kambarage Nyerere, speaking under the theme, the unity of Africa, said among other things, that we have not come here to remind ourselves how important unity is. We know that African unity is significant. And he said, if Africa is to be a great continent and if Africa is to realize our potential, Africans must de-emphasize their Tanzanian-ness. Africans must de-emphasize their Ghanaian-ness. And they must emphasize their Africanness. And he went on to say, I'm not naive in appreciating that we have long been in our little corners, but I'm telling us that out there in the world, they only know us as Africans. And he reminded the audience that there are times when he has gone to Europe and his own colleagues in the leadership in certain parts of the world will ask him, what is happening in Senegal? While he himself is the president of Tanzania. So that is the Africa that we are talking about. So there have been many initiatives to make Africa great. How many of us will forget the new initiative for African development under NEPAD, signed in the year 2001 in Lusaka, Zambia, when Africans took the view once again that in order to grow, we must work together. There have been no shortage of initiatives to bring Africa together. And I remember in the very early days, in the 1960s and in the 1970s, the grand project as conceived by Kwame Nkrumah having failed to take off as it was designed to take off, many African countries took the view that the only way in which we could ultimately have the grand African agenda was to come up with regional development. So we came up with the East African Community, and indeed, I can remember so very vividly, because even in Africa, there were days when Africa worked in the early days. In the early days, many African countries were recording economic growth of anything between 6 and 7%. In the early days after independence, there were areas where Africa was growing in education. In the health, the indices had improved so that infant mortality and maternal mortality indices were positive. We could see that in agriculture, Africa was beginning to feed herself. Africa was adding value to her things. I remember in Nairobi, in public schools, young school children would receive textbooks and exercise books. I remember that classes had libraries. I remember that in those early days, the public transport systems worked. I remember in those days that our agricultural products were receiving the kind of prices that they ought to receive in the world market. I remember in those early days in countries such as Zambia, the kwacha was strong because the copper was being paid for rightly. I remember in those early days in countries such as this one where cocoa, and in the neighboring Cote d'Ivoire when cocoa was being transported and you are receiving the right price. I remember in those early days, diamond from Wadui in Shinyanga and diamond from Botswana and in Namibia were receiving the right price. There was a time in those early days when Africa was indeed moving in some direction. And I remember in East Africa when we had one common currency, when we had one airline, when we had one university and things were moving. In the education sector, I remember students coming from Kenya and traveling to Fura Bay in Freetown. I remember hearing universities such as the University of Education at Winneba. I remember the University of Legon. I remember the University of Nigeria at Nsukka. I remember the University of Maiduguri. And I remember the University of Makerere in Uganda and Dar es Salaam in Tanzania and many other universities. Africa was rising, but something happened. Something happened. Something happened. There are those who think that it was externally induced. They may be right. There are those who think that our leadership was also a contributory factor, and I think they are right. So that there is a sense in which we Africans are also co-authors of our own misfortune. We are co-authors in the sense that there is, and there have been opportunities to make us great. At the beginning of the address, the Vice Chancellor rightly remarked, the Professor rightly remarked that in Africa there were countries that were doing better than South Korea. Kenya was doing better than South Korea. Kenya had a higher GDP than China, Ghana the same, Tanzania the same. Then somehow the Koreans went and left us. The Chinese during our lifetime have left us. The Singaporeans have left us. The Malaysians have left us. The Brazilians have left us. The Vietnamese after the war in 1975 have left us. Who is it? What is it that holds us back? What is it? Is it us? Is it some power? Are we children of a lesser God? What is it that holds us back? Why is it that Africa does not work? Why is it that I'm speaking to you now? Even what we call peace in many African countries is not peace, it's just silence. I've lamented for too long. Now I want to talk about what it is that we can do. But before I do that, let us look at our continent, at this continent called Africa. Our combined GDP, the 54 officially recognized countries, that is assuming that you don't ask the Moroccans about Sahrawi. Our GDP last year combined, the 54 of us combined, all of us, 1.4 billion of us, our goods and services put together, is no more than $2 trillion United States dollars, and I'm being generous about this. And to give you a perspective, the state of California in the United States of America, with a population of slightly under 39 million, has a GDP last year of $3 trillion United States dollars. To give you a perspective, and my good friend, the Honorable Minister from Burundi is here, their GDP last year was no more than 2.3 billion United States dollars. That is exactly the same amount that the state of New York in New York collects in one day. In one day. That is the continent that we are talking about, my mother's